Welcome to the Oregon Fly Fishing Blog. My name is Tony Torrence. We are going to tie a Brazilian. This is a pattern of Tom Larimer's again. We're going to bring our thread back to just in front of the point of the hook. We're going to tie in a tail of golden pheasant breast, and this is a feather that is located on the edges of your skin. And I'm going to pop one of these out. I've taken the material and spread it apart, clipped the tip out, got all the fuzz out. This has a nice natural curve to it, so I'm just going to pull this material back, and this tail is probably a little heavy still, so I'm going to thin this material down a little bit. And then I'll just lay this in here and make a loose wrap. Just a couple loose wraps, actually, and then I'm just going to pull this forward until that little V disappears in where I cut this feather, and you have your tail. And that should be, this is size 3/20/51. That should be just about right there. So I'll bring this up underneath the body just to smooth everything out using Vivas 10-0. Cut this out. Next, we're going to tie in some wire for a rib, and this is Ultra Wire Company's wine-colored brassy. I think I would prefer to use a medium on a size 3, but I didn't have this color in medium. I usually use a red, though it's not the pattern's original color. Next, we're going to dub some STS Trilobal in Claret. I just take a little bit at a time, add it to the thread, and just spin it onto the thread. I'm dubbing this a little heavy because I like this bug to, or this fly to have a lot of material to pick out, make it a little buggier. And I'll just keep adding this dubbing until I get up to the head of the fly. Better to underdo than overdo, otherwise you got a big wad of dubbing that you can't use at the end. You don't really want to tie this body too thick. It is a summer fly and a great comeback fly. I'll just keep adding a little more dub. I know you're probably getting bored with this already, but bear with me. We will be doing more Larimer patterns, so if you enjoy the last two, the green butt purple and this Brazilian, there will be more. And I'll just bring this body up. Want a little more. I like to leave a little space up in front of the eye for, or in front of the head for turtle knots, or if you want to rig this fly with a riffle hitch for a comeback. So we're going to leave a little space in front of our wing and hackle. Now what I'm going to do is, I left a little wad here, so I'm just going to kind of trim this out a little bit. Okay, and I'll bring my wire up through, evenly spacing it. Traditionally be 5 wraps, but I'm going to add a few more in here just to keep this fly together and give it a little more segmentation. Okay, so we've got our wire done. We'll twist it and break it. Now I'll bring in my dubbing teaser and just kind of pick this out a little bit. Just a little. Again, this fly is tied what we call trude style, which is an old reference for a wing with a hackle in the front of it. And I liked, you know, this calls for a black wing. I'm going to use black Arctic fox on this fly. The guard hairs, not the under fur. And I've kind of picked through to get all the under hair out. So I'll just secure this loosely in there and then put a couple hard wraps on it. Wing's a little long, so I'm going to lift it off of there. Place it till I get just about where I want. Okay, so I'll get a couple hard wraps, pull straight down on that. Now I want to put a little bit of flash in here, and this calls for some black crystal flash. And so we'll just take a couple strands of this and do the fold technique like we did with the green butt purple, just to add a little flash to this fly. So I'm going to run that one down there, and then what I'm going to do is pull this over, hook it into place, and run this down this other side. Another technique for getting flash. And then what I'll do is just trim that to length, and that stays in the wing along both sides and blends in nicely. Okay. So I'm going to trim off my hair here, get a little thread going on there, and I may have again gone a little far back. That. We'll see. Next, I need to put on a claret guinea hackle. So I have one chosen, and I will just leave this. I will leave this tip here sticking out, and I'll get a wrap in there. Pull this back, wrap over it, bring my thread forward, grab that little piece, pop it. Okay. Now that I have my hackle secured, I will simply just take my scissors, run them down the back side, and fold this hackle, kind of pushing down and across with the back of the scissors. I'm trying not to be too vigorous because I don't want to break my hackle, obviously. Sometimes they fold easier. And then I will just pull and stroke back these fibers as I come around. Now I've gone too short as usual. I'm going to pull this stem back and tie it in just so it doesn't come loose. And then I'll just come in here and gently snip that out. Build a little head. Nice thing about tying these trude style is you will get a tiny, tiny head as long as you cover your thread underneath and stop your material in front of it. And this is kind of a big Brazilian. I generally fish these in fives and sevens, but this is a three just for demonstrative purposes. And there you have a Tom Larimer, Brazilian. Thank you for watching the Oregon Fly Fishing Blog.